all said and done, it will be the largest renewable energy park in the entire nation. This past May, in conjunction with top officials from Genesee County, Livingston, Lapeer, and St. Clair, I announced the formation of the Economic Growth Alliance. All five counties, including Oakland, will collaborate on joint opportunities for economic growth, diversification, and work for positive legislation that could impact our counties. This collaboration brings together several key assets that will fuel business development opportunities, including the Blue Water Bridge in Port Huron, Interstate 69 and the I-96 US 23 M-59 corridors, Flint Bishop's International Airport, and Oakland County's Medical Main Street Initiative. The most valuable asset that the Alliance possesses is the skilled workforce drawn from the more than 2 million people living within this five-county region. As it relates to our new Economic Growth Alliance, I have an exciting announcement to make about this group. My Information Technology Department in Oakland County, in conjunction with AT&T, is pleased to announce the launching of a contest within the EGA, the Economic Growth Alliance, called the OakGov Challenge. Well, since this is a contest, obviously, it's going to be a prize. Winners of the OakGov Challenge will spare prize money, totaling $10,000 put up by our friends at AT&T. The OakGov Challenge will provide an opportunity for local tech-savvy programmers to create new ideas and applications that could either be published as a web application for use on a PC or as a smartphone application for use on the iPhone or the Google Android and so forth. In this public-private partnership, we hope to end up with new applications that takes a plethora of public data that we have stored in the county and make that data more accessible to you, the citizens. Now, I certainly want to thank AT&T for its generous financial support of this contest. And I want to shout out to all those innovative and tech-talented programmers in Oakland, Genesee, Livingston, Lapeer, and St. Clair. You can get all the information you need to enter this contest at our website, oakgovchallenge.com. Again, the goal of this contest is to develop applications that will stimulate innovation within the community, promote the skills of IT developers throughout the EGA region, and ultimately enhance government-to-citizen communication and information sharing. So good luck. We continue to entice Hollywood to film here in Oakland County. Last year, 14 motion picture projects were in film scenes in 16 of our communities. In the coming year, if you go to see Red Dawn, a movie about the communist Chinese invasion of the United States, you will recognize Troy, Royal Oak, Pontiac, and Highland Township in some of those scenes. Or if you buy a ticket to see Highland Park, a movie about one man's efforts to save the public library in this distressed enclave of Detroit, you will see parts of Holly, Oakland Township, and Meadowbrook Hall. I don't know how Meadowbrook Hall gets in that story there, Gary. With all the excitement caused by the film industry in this community, I can't tell you how many times I've been mistaken for Brad Pitt. It just... maybe it was Orson Welles. Movies are not mere life in the fast lane here in Oakland County. They are becoming permanent presence. Last month, Ferndale-based S3 Entertainment Group announced the opening of its film and production studio in South Oakland County. S3 is known for recent movie projects such as Clint Eastwood's Gran Torino and the newly released comedy Youth in Revolt. They have converted the old Casper Machine property into a site that includes a 25,000 square foot soundstage, 10,000 square feet of offices, and a screening room among the amenities. S3 says that they have six film projects scheduled for 2010, which will create 1,000 new jobs. And further evidence of the film industry's investment in Oakland County is the decision of the Raleigh Studios and Endeavor happens to be Hollywood's biggest talent agency, to open a new state-of-the-art studio at Centerpoint in Pontiac. This project has the backing of local business leaders such as Al Taubman and John McColton and Linda Nelson, as well as the economic developers from the state of Michigan, Oakland County, and the city of Pontiac. Their $60 million investment is expected to generate 3,600 new jobs by 2013 with an economic impact of $368 million. So there's a display outside if you want to take a look at it. Our local universities are hopping on the movie-making caravan as well. Oakland County Community College and Lawrence Technological University are developing programs to train students for jobs in the local film industry. Deputy Executive Ken Rogers heads up My Automation Alley, a consortium of high-tech companies created in 1998 to compete with the nation's other technology corridors such as Silicon Valley, Boston's Route 128, and North Carolina's Research Park Triangle. Automation Alley started with 43 companies, and today it has grown to more than 1,000 companies in eight counties. In 2009, seven area businesses, Lawrence Tech University, and two economic developers accompanied Automation Alley on a trade mission to Israel. Israeli companies are on the cutting edge when it comes to technology development, and Automation Alley is working hard to connect Oakland County businesses with Israel's high-tech sector. Other such trade missions since 2001 have generated more than $140 million in contracts for Automation Alley companies and created 200 new jobs. Also, Automation Alley assisted more than 300 companies with entrepreneurial services, and since 2003, they have invested nearly $5 million in 25 local companies, creating 150 additional jobs. No Oakland County taxpayers' funds were involved, I should tell you that. In 2010, Automation Alley will be opening up a military office within its Troy headquarters. As you know, the military is a multi-billion dollar industry and is always looking for qualified business suppliers within the private sector. Automation Alley plans for this military office to be a place to cultivate relationships among the Pentagon, the military contractors, and the area businesses, so Oakland County manufacturers can have the opportunity to bid on military contracts. We know it's first impressions or lasting impressions, and that is true in business as well as in our private lives. And when potential business investors from around the world fly into Oakland County International Airport, they're going to have a first impression, and we want it to be a positive one. That is why this spring, Oakland County International Airport will break ground on a new, modern, green terminal, replacing the outdated 50-year-old facility. Now, this might surprise some of you in the audience tonight, but did you know that the Oakland County International Airport is the second busiest airport in the state of Michigan, second only to Metro Detroit? Last year, we serviced more than 500,000 passengers, and most, if not all, Fortune 500 companies landed their jets there. Well, they used to before Obama took all their planes, you know. The existing, I'm just kidding, my Democrat friends here in the commission. The existing terminal is obsolete. It no longer portrays the high-tech image of Oakland County in which we pride ourselves. Not only will the new terminal have a modern look, but it will be right-sized, eliminating excess space that is not used in the current facility. It will be the first Oakland County building to be LEED certified. LEED stands for Leadership in Energy Environmental Design. Now, that's an independent third-party rating that confirms the new terminal building will be energy efficient and least impactful on our environment. Not only will it be the gateway to Oakland County, but will also serve as the airport administration office, house both the United States Customs Office and local law enforcement, and offer a visitor's conference room. When the terminal is complete, passengers who deplaned at the Oakland County International Airport will have a positive impression that Oakland County is a high-tech place to live and work. Now, how much will this cost you, the taxpayers? Nada, nothing. My Central Services Director, David Vanderveen, applied for and received over $2 million in federal grant money to partially fund the new terminal's construction. The balance of the money required to construct the terminal comes from fees that are collected from users who land at the airport and pay landing fees and buy fuel. There is no direct cost to the county's general fund. Now, we also, this past year, extended the runway by 320 feet. It's now 6,825 feet long. What that means is aircraft can now fly nonstop, that's without fueling, to the West Coast, Mexico, Europe, and Asia, all business destinations. Besides that, the airport currently has a $175 million economic impact on our region.